Good morning, Pipers. Hope you're well. We're good. The sun is shining. Maybe summer's coming. And, yeah, all good. It's been a while. It's been busy at the day job, so I haven't really had time for making pipes as such. This is a new pipe that I made for myself. You can see there was a pit on the side, quite a big pit. Obviously not good enough for a customer, but more than good enough for me. So I finished it with a 410 shotgun shell and a camo stem. A true redneck pipe, which brings me on to why I made it a redneck pipe. Some of you are probably chuckling now, because if you follow me on Instagram, you'll know why. And that's another thing, Instagram. So my Instagram account was hacked by some Bitcoin miner, whatever they are, posting pictures of flash cars and houses, pretending to me, saying that I'd made it all with Bitcoin. I should be so lucky. I wouldn't be flaunting it if I had. And I can't get into that account now because they changed all the passwords and contact details and God knows what else. And Instagram don't want to know. So if you're not already following my new account, it'll be in the description below. And that is bjvpipes.secondcoming. And obviously, I'm going to start again, which is what it is. But funny enough, on one of my first posts I put up there, which was for the last pipe I did, the Natural Dublin, a guy who's given me grief before, and probably a lot of you know him, some might follow him, some might like him, who knows, I don't know, but he's a bit of a idiot, I think. And he commented on that post, no sense of proportion, no eye for colours, rudimentary pipe making, and this is vintage_pipes_nightmares, as a YouTube channel as well. I think they call him Silvio or something, he's Romanian. He's given me grief on YouTube before, and countless other people that I know. So obviously he gets kicks out of it. I don't give a shit really. It's nice to have a bit of interaction with him back and forth. Makes me smile. But at one point then he replied to someone else and put, "You've had four pipes before starting making these atrocities," which I don't know, I'm on like pipe 300 and some. "You've learned to make pipes by looking at pictures. A classic shaped pipe shank is always thicker at the ball and is tapering towards the stem. No movement, no sense of proportion, just bulky redneck style pipes." Did he not realise that's a compliment for me? I'm as fucking redneck as you can get in the UK. I fucking love shooting, I love smoking, I love drinking, I love fucking camo shit trucks. It's like Jesus. So this pipe is in honour to you, vintage_fucking-whatever-you're-called. This is a redneck pipe, and I fucking love them, so go fuck yourself, mate. Anyway, if we ever bump into him, my mate down at fucking Morrison's, the security guard, Pete Bedford, big shout out for you, mate. He's going to fucking knock him out. So, yeah, we've had a laugh about it, but I got a new pipe out of it, and it's a pretty redneck pipe. What? Shotgun shell and camo. Yeah, I'd say so. Smoking in it some fantastic Capstan Blue. We all love Capstan Blue, don't we? And this is... is that an 8 or a 5? I don't know if it's from 3-18 or 3-15. Probably 18. So it's got, what, 5 years on it at least. And very nice it is too. Beautiful smoke. Very nice. So, I have got two new pipes that are going to go on the website. They'll be on by the time you're watching this. And we'll start with this Dublin. I'll pop that pipe down. Pop my glasses on. Let's concentrate on these pipes. So, we've got a Dublin. And I haven't done this rustication for ages, but the reason for doing it is one of my shooting buddies who smokes cigars has actually decided to take up pipe smoking. So he came round here the other night and we tried some samples and that, and obviously he needed a pipe to smoke. So I gave him one of my old pipes that I'd rejuvenated for him, and it was in this style of rustication. And I thought, you know what, I used to love that rustication. And so I've done it again. It's like, I guess it's this tree bark style rustication, diamond cut, whatever you want to call it, but it's very nice on the hand. Smooth rim, English boxwood ring, and polyester this stem in a briar style pattern, faux briar, I guess. So maybe that's slightly better pattern. We'll shove that to the top. There's your nice deep flute, which, going back to our friend Silver, whoever, who called me pipes, looking at his account, he smokes a lot of his pipes seem to be Dunhills, Shadertons, Astley's, you know, them sort of pipes, the older pipes, factory pipes, essentially, that people are charging a fortune for, like Dunhill. And obviously, aesthetically very pleasing if you like that classic style. And aesthetics are in the eye of the beholder. But you cannot get away from the fact that a factory pipe is just a hole drilled straight through there, with no fluting whatsoever. If you're lucky, you'll get a little half moon cut here, but it's not fluting. It don't flute the smoke. The airway will be one straight drill bit from like probably 3.5 to 4 mil all the way through, where I use a 3.7 that tapers down, and then as it flares out here with your fluting, it spreads that smoke about, gives a far more enjoyable draw and spread of smoke into your mouth. That's just mechanics, that's engineering. You know what I mean? Aesthetics aside, my pipes will smoke better. I've got Dunhill. I've got Dunhill and I've got, what, 4 Castellos. I had to flute them all, even though I floated them myself. After the fact, they still don't smoke as well because that drilling isn't tapered the same as when you do it from new. And then pipes just sit there now, expensive waste of money. Should move them on, really. Anyway, back to this pipe. No filter. Weighs 40 grams from memory. All the sizes will be on the website, on the page where you can buy it. Some video on Instagram and such like, obviously. You can see it here anyway. I would say it's about 5 inch long. Yeah, so there's that one, the Dublin. And then the other one is a bent Rhodesian, half blast and then a smooth rim. Two rings on this one. English boxwood ring again, and this is the Eldridge Teal Abyss Swirl, I think he called it. Very vibrant. Again, nice deep floating. And no filter on this one. This pipe, again, probably 5 inch. This one weighs 50 grams, I believe. The bowl, we're more like that finger. I would say probably about 30, 60 maybe. The bowl on the other one, by the way, as well, is, you can't really see, but it is a tapered bowl, so it goes down to a point, obviously to follow the Dublin kind of shape. So although it's a deeper bowl, it's obviously narrows the bottom third. There we have it. Two pipes, and they'll be on the website. We'll be at the old shooting range this afternoon. And TV-wise, it's just Soprano still. I am on the final season and try to drag it out because I don't want it to end, but we all know what happens anyway. I've seen it, like, I don't know. I must have gone round a good 5 times the series, I reckon, and then obviously just watched odd episodes, especially like Pine Barrens and such like. Oh, dozens of times. Love it, but hopefully get a lot more time sat out smoking instead of being stuck in the shack. Not that there's all majorly wrong with that, but it's nice to be out, I guess. So I'm going to get back to my Capstan Blue in my little hillbilly pipe, and wish you all a good bank holiday weekend in the UK and everywhere in the world, else in the world. Just enjoy your smokes as ever, and stay smoky, my friends.